Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss an update.
So the next 12 months, or whatever time it is, guess what brand you're wearing?
Yeah, look around.
Which brand are you wearing?
You're wearing, yeah, what does that say loudly? Yaar, bil khul ke bolo.
HUL, yeah? So it's a brand that's actually stuck with you for life now. So this is your brand and this is the company that you represent. What really goes into this place is not as much as the hard part of the company, but it's a soft part of the company, which is why it's called the School for. Well, it's called the School for CEOs, but it's 27 years or so. I finished in May in this company. And actually, I must tell you, it's an incredible journey. I know you're looking at it and collapsing and saying you must have joined really young. I must have been 2 years old or something when you joined, yeah? But it's true, actually, you know, 27 years passes in a jiffy. So when somebody comes and tells you I've spent 20 years in a company or 25 years in a company, how do you react? It's mind-numbing. How do you spend 27 years in a career? If I look at my journey of 27 years, I've been across several different jobs in several different places. And the kind of thoughts that it leaves me is, what is it that actually works in this company that makes this company such a fine place to work in? After 27 years, I still feel it's the best company in the world. Not best company in India. I think it's the finest company in the world. Yeah? And if I can feel that way after a quarter of a century of working in a place, there must be something in it, right or not? Don't think of your work as only being work, 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 work. The first lesson I learned in my life is that actually life and work and life work together. So you must have something outside of work, because I also think it brings a lot into your work. It brings a lot into the kind of leader that you are. Three thoughts about the world and how it's changing and how it's different from how the world was when I started working, when I was on my summer internship. I think the first one is clearly it's an incredible VUCA world. It is an incredibly volatile market, and that has implications for the kind of leadership you bring to your table. It has leadership, it has implications also in terms of how you are going to develop yourselves as the leader, which is very different from our times, because when we grew up as managers, it was VUCA, but it wasn't as fast as this. Second is clearly anytime, anywhere. Yeah? So the world is connected. Cisco has done a study on the impact of data and technology on people's lives. Two-thirds people in India, when they get up, the first thing they look at is their mobile phones. So you're connected at any point in time. Fact is today, you're never really isolated from work. So you take an action today, the consequences of it are across the globe in a matter of minutes. So the way you manage, the way you lead, the way you handle people, the way you handle your own teams has got to be very, very different. And third is, of course, large corporation. So when Spider-Man's uncle, you remember what he says? With great power comes great responsibility. Yeah, I think the role of large corporations was always strong, but it has gone up tremendously. And if you look at some very simple stats that I'm very fond of quoting, if you take the turnover of the top three companies in the world, you know what the top three companies in the world are by revenue, not market cap? There's Walmart, there's State Grid, and there's Sinopec. The combined turnover of these three corporations, so $1.2 trillion in revenue, do you know how much that is? That is more than the GDP of the combined GDP of the bottom 110 countries in the world. What does that tell you? The economic power and muscle of the top three corporations is larger than 100 countries. It means that as large corporations, you have the economic power to make huge change, and you have the trust of people that you will make the change. Therefore, the role of large corporations is no longer saying that, okay, we'll just get a profit and loss and a balance sheet, we'll make some good money. The impact for you on social change is very large. So which is different, because 20 years ago, people expected the government to do everything. So in your age, as you go forward, remember the three things that are going to be super critical for you. Your world is going to be very, very volatile and VUCA. So don't say, this is out of syllabus. Ji, hame toh maloom hi nahi hai. Imagine if your marketing professor asked you a finance question, you'll say, that's wrong number, sir. Ye toh marle nahi hai. But in the world outside, there is nothing that's outside syllabus, because the world is very, very volatile. As you go into your summer internships, keep this in mind, that there is no defined syllabus. Don't start by saying, but it wasn't in the charter. Because you've got a charter, but the charter is an indication. It's a direction. It's an expression of intent. Yeah? It's not intended to limit you. Your world is going to be very connected, and therefore be very clear of the fact that data is available everywhere, it's accessible to anybody. And remember the third one, which is, what is your role in large corporations? So take charge of the projects, take full ownership of the impact you want to create. Don't lose time, because 8 weeks passes like this, 27 years passes like this. Yeah? The second is, have purpose. All of us worry about the fact that, we don't know what we want to do. I don't know whether I want to do FMCG, or I want to go to consulting, or I want to do a PhD, or I want to join the government of India. It doesn't matter. Create a sense of purpose for yourself for the time that it works for you, and you can change it if you want. Our company is a company of purpose. As leaders, that's the first thing you need to do. Remember, people don't follow you because you're a boss. They follow you because they believe in where you're taking them. Right? Gandhiji wasn't anyone's boss. He wasn't one of those guys who made a very fiery speech or anything like that, but he had a very clear point of view of where he wanted to take the country, and 100 million people wanted to follow him on that. Third one I would say is value your roots. Don't forget your roots ever. Don't forget where you come from. Yeah. We have very solid middle class ethics, middle class values, which is about a sense of fairness, a sense of justice, a sense of professionalism, a sense of ethics in terms of work, and just hard work. So never look back to your roots and say, you know what, I'm not one of those rich blokes, or I'm not somebody who doesn't come from a sexy institute or whatever it is. You're the kind of person we want. Remember that and be secure in that. But be curious about what's happening in the world. How can something outside actually be used in the business? Yeah? How do we make sure our consumers are taken care of? How do we make sure our people, our business is constantly growing? And this is the time to start building it.